Not only is Christina Paul an award-winning singer and songwriter, she's reaching countless others with her missions organization. Christina joins us today with the backstory of her music and her ministry. Welcome to The Harvest Show.
Thank you, Valerie. Thanks for having me. Hi, Stefan.
Wow, Christina, you have an amazing backstory. I mean, just kind of take us back. You grew up in India. Mm-hmm. Your parents were Christian singers mm-hmm. as well. Take it from there.
Yes, growing up in a Christian family, my parents are Christian recording artists. Mm-hmm. My mom is a signed Christian recording artist in India by the big label HMV. Mm-hmm. And so we did ministry. We toured around India and went to a lot of places and sang for the glory of God. And we raised church building funds through our concerts. And we released, I released 7 Indian albums. And after that, I got my degree in computer science. Mm-hmm. And as a custom in India, you know, I got, my parents arranged my marriage. And
okay,
I got married.
So stop
to my,
right there. Yeah. That's kind of hard for
Pause.
Us, you know, for women in the West to kind of wrap our brains around someone arranging a marriage. But you, I mean, sometimes when I hear about arranged marriages, mm-hmm. Then sometimes it's negative, what
right.
we hear about them. But you are madly in love with this man. I met him in the green room. Tell us about, how does that process unfold?
Well, my parents actually looked out for a life partner for me.
Okay.
And a common friend who knew both our families introduced Paul's family to us, and we exchanged photographs, and we liked, I liked his picture. And that's where it all started. And then he flew, he was working in Nashville, Tennessee.
Hmm.
So he flew to India over to see me, and we had a chat for 30 minutes. And we got engaged. And 2 months later, we got married.
Wow, that's
and
quick.
That
so I was
going to
say, how long is this courting
know,
process?
Right?
And the families, do they normally know one another for a long time before this kind of thing? But this sounds like it was
pretty quick. Yeah, pretty quick. And I completely relied on faith.
Mm-hmm.
You know, God. You know, relied on, completely on God. I've been praying for my life partner since I was 13 years old. So I kind of felt the peace, inner peace in my heart mm-hmm. when I met him. So I knew that, God was not going to, give me a person. It just all worked out really
yeah,
good.
God.
Yes,
praise
and we've been
God.
Married for 16 years now.
And you got two?
Two kids,
yeah.
Yes,
yeah,
Joanne and Matthew.
Tell us a little bit about your experience in the faith. You know, growing up in a Christian home
mm-hmm.
with very active and
That's
dynamic
right.
Parents who are sharing the gospel, mm-hmm. We still have to come to an individual
exactly.
reckoning or
right.
or acceptance of Christ
right.
as Lord and Savior. So how did that happen for you?
Yes, even though I grew up in a Christian home, Jesus actually became real to me when I went to college. I started spending more time with him, personal devotions.
Mm-hmm.
So that's when I started walking closely with him. It's like an everyday interaction with the Lord. And that's where he became real to me. And every time after that, you know, it's like he has been there for me throughout my life. And when I got married and we gave birth to my daughter, Joanne, she had a sickness called neutropenia, which is a blood disorder, and God healed her.
Wow.
So I was just clinging on to God, you know, during that phase of my life. And it has grown me much stronger. I've grown much stronger in faith. And so there are many areas just God has been growing me.
Mm-hmm.
Recently, he has been growing me in compassion for people.
Mm-hmm.
So I've been just moved with compassion when I hear stories and I want to just pray with them, cry with them. And God has been just working in my life miraculously and been stretching me
mm-hmm.
and pruning me, if you will. So.
Well, you just talked about that compassion. Is that one of the reasons you started your missions organization? What's the name of it?
The name of the missions organization is Christ for All Ministries. Christ-all-for-ministries.com.
Mm-hmm.
That's the website. And it's just an amazing organization. Basically, it was a vision of my husband.
Mm-hmm.
He wanted to start a missions organization. God spoke to him and he shared it with me. And we both, you know, I had to feel it too in my heart for me to be supportive of what he is doing.
Mm-hmm.
And I prayed about it. And God, you know, showed me that's the way to go. And that missionary organization has touched so many people's lives.
Well, you're also touching people with your music, your beautiful voice, Lord
Thank
of
you.
All. Where did this CD come from?
God has been doing so many things in my life, and He is awesome. He is so wonderful. And those songs that I've written are coming straight from my heart, mm-hmm. my praise and reverence for the sovereign God. Mm-hmm. And so Lord of All is just, and all of the songs that you see, like Touch of Grace and How Long, O Lord, which is like Psalm 13, mm-hmm. that talks about one of the difficult times that we had. We, as a family, faced a very difficult time like a few years ago.
What happened?
And basically, those are the details that I can't discuss. Mm-hmm. But, you know, God was there throughout mm-hmm. the time. And, you know, that Psalm 13 is all about how long, O Lord,
mm-hmm. right.
will you hide your face from me? It's not like God is going to hide his face from us. But we, when we are faced with trials and tribulations, sometimes we want the answer so quick. Mm-hmm. But God delivers it at the right time. Mm-hmm. And His will is perfect for us. Mm-hmm. And His grace is sufficient for us.
Well, you,
so it's just awesome. Yeah.
You probably sing about what you learned during that time. Mm-hmm. How are people responding to it?
People love the song. And to mention, just one of the songs is Touch of Grace. Mm-hmm. And when we released it in my church, there was an overwhelming response for that. And there are a group of women meet on a regular basis who have lost their spouses. They came and told me, like, you have no idea, Christina, how these songs minister to us, especially Touch of Grace. It talks about, like, how God's grace is hovering over us, even though we don't realize it. God's protecting us. So they said that it just speaks to their heart every single time mm-hmm. when they listen to it.
Is that your favorite song on the album?
Yes, I have actually a few favorites.
Well, tell us about a couple more.
Okay, How Long, O Lord mm-hmm. is because it's very dear
personal.
To my heart.
Yeah.
Yes, it's very personal. Touch of Grace. And Lord of All, of course. Mm-hmm. I want it to be really orchestral. And because, you know, it's just praising God and just, singing about His attributes. It's mm-hmm. just, I wanted it to be magnificent. So just, I'm doing my best there. So Lord of All is one of my favorites. And Come Holy Spirit. That seems to be a lot of other people's favorite. Mm-hmm. They say because of the simplicity of the song, it's Come Holy Spirit is a lot of people's favorites.
Yeah,
yes.
Yeah. Going back to India, mm-hmm. That's obviously world's most populated or mm-hmm. getting close to the world's most populated nation, over 1 billion people. It seems
right.
that it's been a huge investment of Christianity and gospel and missionaries and evangelists and church planters since the late 1800s. But there's still a very small minority of Christianity taking root and hold. What's
right.
it like ministering in that nation?
Ministering in India is really, southern parts of India, its disciple Thomas mm-hmm. came and he spread the gospel already there. So we have a lot of Christians in southern parts of India.
Mm-hmm. From the first church, the early
yes,
church.
Yes, yeah. exactly. And so if you think about the Indian populations, even though it's billion, it's 7% of the Indian populations are Christians. Mm-hmm. And 70 million Christians are there. Mm-hmm. So it's a huge number. But there is very slim Christian population in northern parts of India because of persecution or just...
That's what I was
yes,
wondering.
Yes, mm-hmm. there's a lot of persecution. A lot of the Christians, mm-hmm. they are not coming out and saying that they are Christians because
yeah.
they are afraid of their lives. So mm-hmm. that's where it is. So, but, you know, it's beautiful. I mean, through our missionary organization, we have sent 26 missionaries to the northern parts of India. Mm-hmm. So Maharashtra and Uttar Pradesh are the parts where the missionaries are actually mm-hmm. in the field
yeah.
spreading the gospel. And there are 500 people got saved. And they meet on a weekly basis regularly on Sundays and worship God.
Wonderful.
So that is an awesome thing. And
yeah.
one of the key persons is Reverend John Kirubakaran. He was one of the key reasons that we were able to put this missionary organization together mm-hmm. because he is a co-founder of this organization, and he is in India. He's the backbone for this ministry.
Wonderful.
And he's supporting us.
Well, thank you so much for sharing your story. So interesting, Christina. To connect with Christina, go to ChristinaPaul.com, or you can go to harvest-tv.com and click on the link for her, to her new project, Lord of All. Christina, you're going to sing again for us. What's the name of your song?
Beat of My Heart.
Beat of My Heart. And still to come.